Now, today's top stories and Power of 5 weather from News 5, sponsored by Akron Children's Hospital.
Good Sunday morning, Northeast Ohio, on this 24th of October. 1 week from today is the 31st, known, of course, for Halloween, but it's of note for another reason. Well, that too. A third reason, then. It is the deadline for Ohio's Redistricting Commission to come to an agreement on new congressional maps. How's it going? Not good.
At the close of the state legislative redistricting process last month, it resulted in a party line vote on new districts, now being challenged by three lawsuits in the state Supreme Court. Republican Secretary of State Frank LaRose warned his colleagues,
"This process will be different. It is not going to work this way next time."
And he's been right. It hasn't, because while they came under fire for the way they drew those maps, they at least did draw some. To date, there hasn't even been a single meeting ahead of the October 31st deadline to even begin the process. This despite calls from Democratic co-chair Vernon Sykes and LaRose himself to do so.
"It is time for this commission to meet. I can tell you that I've been working on my drafts of different ideas of how I think that we could reach a compromise. But until we can all come together as a commission and talk about those sort of basic principles of how we can draw these maps and reach that 10-year consensus, the clock's going to run out if we don't meet soon. And that would be deeply disappointing to me, John."
He's not alone.
"I have no idea what they're waiting for."
Catherine Turser is executive director of Common Cause Ohio. She's one of the people who fought for the constitutional change in 2018 that created this process.
"There are only 10 more days. So we have to assume that they are just not going to actually get together, that they're not actually going to create 10-year congressional maps, and they're going to leave it to the state legislature."
Yeah, it's the same legislature that failed to act on the drawing of these congressional districts by a September 30th deadline, which then causes to go to the 7-member redistricting commission, would then get the job back November 1st.
"If it's complicated to do bipartisan map making with 7 people, it is definitely going to be complicated with 132 people.
That's why LaRose is trying, in a sense, to get the band back together.
"I want to avoid this going to the courts. I don't want to see this result in more litigation. I want to see us as Republicans and Democrats come together as statesmen and women and solve this for Ohioans."
And they have now just a week to do so. Well, the news cycle was dominated in part this week by the sad story of the missionaries from an Ohio ministry that were kidnapped in Haiti. It brought immediate reaction from elected leaders across the state, but few of them understand the situation in Haiti better than Governor Mike DeWine.
For more than 2 decades, Governor Mike DeWine and his wife Fran have been visiting Haiti, working with a group that runs a school named for their late daughter Becky, who was killed in a car crash in 1993 at the age of 22. DeWine was saddened when he learned an Ohio ministry was the target of these kidnappings, but says the one thing that always struck him when visiting Haiti were the number of Ohioans there.
"I think that's something to remember. We have a lot of exposure. A lot of Ohioans who are, in fact, in Haiti."
The Becky DeWine School they support is run by a Massachusetts-based Catholic group, Hands Together, run by Father Tom Hagen, who gave the opening prayer at DeWine's inauguration.
"Look, it's a tough place to operate. Father Tom, one of the things that he has had to do is to broker peace agreements between the rival gangs that run City Soleil, where his school is. And the only, you know, he has to do that if he wants to keep his schools open."
Earlier this week, I spoke with Father Hagen in Haiti. He said following the assassination of the country's president in July, the lawlessness has only gotten worse.
"There's no police presence. There's absolutely no police at all. None in City Soleil. And what's eerie is you see these police stations there."
As Governor Mike DeWine mentioned, to continue to operate the schools and feed the poor, he deals daily with rival gangs in the area, meeting just the day before we spoke with one that he learned was looking to kill one of his workers.
"I said, I heard you put a word out to have him killed. And the report I'm getting is he did. He told all his soldiers if they see him anywhere around, they'd shoot him right away. So that discussion was about my saying, you know, if you're going to attack him, you're attacking us too. And it's, you know, we're trying to work together."
Over the last 30 years, he estimates they've had about a dozen of their staff, which numbers around 700, killed.
"Every time we put people on top, there's a good chance they could get killed."
He said the 400 Mwoza gang being blamed for the kidnapping of the Ohio missionaries is only located about a mile away. I asked if he had any dealings with them.
"Not so much. All the gangs, of course, have some connection to one another. That particular gang has a reputation of killing people and kidnapping. They're really a very evil group.
He said he spoke with a different gang leader about them and the heat they're bringing.
I said, this is going to look bad for you. So I don't get into kidnapping. Most of them I don't think are into kidnapping. But yes, I mean, they know that.
Still, he believes deep down, many of them do what they do because they have no other options.
I really do believe that they have worth and they have value. And honestly, John, if you could just get them jobs, there's 80% unemployment. Like the top gang leader, you know what he says? I would love to be able to drive a truck. That's all he wants to do.
Way of Democracy 2021, I'm John Kasich. Enjoy your Sunday.
We're starting off pretty quiet, but that's not going to be the scenario the entire day. We have this system that's down to our south that's going to lift to the north and increase our rain chances as it does so. We'll see waves of rain today, tonight, and on Monday. We'll first see more clouds, temperatures slightly higher. Widespread rain is going to be likely. Futurecast showing us as we get into the afternoon, widespread showers tonight, likely to see the heaviest rain, especially in our northern communities.
Sponsored by Akron Children's Hospital.